children. How are you all? I know you are all doing good. Take care of yourself. It's very hot. Summer started. But you know, God will take care of you. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you, Lord, for the life. Thank you, Lord, for the love and care and protection. Thank you, Lord, for Jesus Christ, who died on the cross of Calvary for our sins. Thank you, Lord, for the life which you have given us. Lord, as we are going to tell the story of Jesus, help all the children to understand and help them to understand and keep their minds and practice their daily life. We are sinners, Lord. Forgive our sins and shortcomings. Once again, I'm submitting all the children. Help them take care of them. These few mercies I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, the title of the story is Not Afraid of the Rulers. Not Afraid of the Rulers. So last week we had learned that they're beautiful. Their crippled man was sitting and begging for money for his food and for his clothes. So Peter and John, when they went there, the man was asking them for the money. So Peter and John, they said, we don't have any money, but in the name of Jesus, get up and walk. So powerful those words. So, you know, immediately the crippled man, he started walking, he started running, he started jumping. He was so happy. And even Peter and John, they were also very happy. And many of the people, they were happy seeing this crippled man started walking. But someone was not happy. You know who? Satan. Satan was not at all happy. Satan wants this crippled man to sit near the gate, beautiful. And you know, even Satan was not happy to know people about Jesus. And Satan doesn't want Peter and John talk about Jesus, the story about Jesus, and even he doesn't want them to tell the world about Jesus. Satan was quite upset. So, what Satan did, you know? He spoiled the minds of rulers and soldiers. And they want to catch hold of Peter and John. Satan doesn't want people to know about Jesus. But Jesus, you know, he's always very loving and kind to the people. So now, Satan, he spoiled the minds of the rulers and the soldiers. And because of that, they took Jesus and made him to die on the cross. But God did not leave him. God told Jesus and told him to come out of him too. He is risen again. So, Satan just wants to know about Jesus, the story about Jesus. So, now the soldiers and the priests and the rulers, you know what they did? They saw the crippled man started walking and jumping. They also just want the crippled man to walk. They knew that Peter and John, they are the one who did it. They knew about it. Perfectly their thought was right. But you know, Satan was behind the scene and he wants the soldiers and the rulers and the priests, they want to catch hold of Peter and John. And they want to put these two men in the prison. So they asked Peter and John, who made this crippled man to walk and jump? Peter knew, and people also knew about it. So Peter and John, really, he knew what to say to these priests and the rulers. You know what? He said that Jesus, in the name of Jesus, they were able to heal the people. Boldly, they were not afraid, so loud and clear, they were able to tell. So now, these people, they didn't like it. They were sad and upset because Peter and John boldly they could say about it, talk about Jesus. So these people said, if you stop talking about Jesus, you will be released from this prison. If not, we are going to trouble you. But these two disciples, Peter and John, they were not afraid of these people, priests and the rulers. They were boldly saying, whom shall we worship? Jesus or you? God or you? Boldly they were able to say to these people, and they don't like it. They don't want to be talked like that. They were quite upset. So that whole night, these two disciples, Peter and John, they were in the prison. They were not afraid. So next morning, they were brought in front of the rulers. So, these people, rulers and the priests, they were all together. And they were thinking what to say to these two disciples. How can we stop these two disciples to talk about Jesus? They knew everything. They have seen Jesus love and care, and they have seen his miracles, and they heard a lot of stories. Now, this man asking these two people to stop talking about Jesus. So they were talking, and they sent these two men outside. And these men were talking, "We know that in the name of Jesus, we were able to heal this crippled man. We know everything, but how can we trouble these two disciples?" So they planned, and these two men, they brought them again to be in front of the priests and the rulers, and these men were angry. They said to this Peter and John, "If you talk about Jesus to the people, then you will be in the trouble. We are going to keep you in the prison forever." So these two disciples, they were not afraid. Brave Peter and brave John, they chose to obey God. They were not at all afraid of these rulers. They knew that Jesus would help them in every way. So these rulers and the priests told the disciples again not to talk about Jesus, you know, and then they let them go out. So immediately Peter and John, they rushed and they went. They met other disciples happily. And you know what they told them? "Jesus, we knew surely Jesus would help." And one thing they said, how Peter and John hurried to tell other disciples how Jesus and the Holy Spirit had helped them talk to the rulers. Brave Peter, brave John, boldly, loudly, and clearly, they asked, "Who do you think we should obey? You or God?" That is the question they asked these rulers and the priests. Now, when they went and told the other disciples, they were very happy. They had been praying that God would help Peter and John, and He had heard their prayers. So down on their knees went the disciples to thank God for His loving and care. Aren't you glad, children? Aren't you glad that God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit helped Peter and John? They will help you know what to say when you are telling others about Jesus too. When we talk about Jesus, when we tell the story of Jesus, the evil people, those who are soldiers to the Satan, they always try to catch hold of the people, those who are talking about Jesus. They like to trouble the people. So children, be careful, be brave, stand firm, just like Peter and John. Don't worry. Talk about Jesus. Tell the people the story of Jesus, how much He loved and cared for you and for me. Tell the people, and they will listen. God will change their minds, just like the Holy Spirit, Jesus, and God will change the top minds of these rulers and the priests. So also, when we are in the trouble, God is there to take care of us. Don't worry for anything. Be brave, just like Peter and John. So the Bible says, Isaiah 43 chapter 10th verse, "Ye are my witnesses, saith the Lord, and my servant who I have chosen." So we are all God's servants. We are all helpers for God. We should witness for God. Whatever comes on the way, be brave. Talk about Jesus. Tell the people about Jesus, the story of Jesus. The moral of the story is, Jesus will help us know what to say when we are telling others about Him. When we are talking about Jesus, the story of Jesus, He always there to help us what to say, what to talk, how to talk. He will guide us. All that we have to submit wholeheartedly to Him. He will take care of us. So children, when you're in the trouble, don't worry. Talk, tell about Jesus. Be brave like Peter and John. He will take care of us. The Holy Spirit will lead us and guide us. All that we have to submit fully to Him, so that He will do the best. Thank you for listening to the story. Again, next week we'll meet. Till then, God be with us. God bless you all. Take care. And now we are going to hear a song.
Us that cast our worst for life, to a kind of fair happy where my father feels like I am bound from promised land. I am bound for the promised land. I am back for the promise. Our all the one is the different shine one and turn. There Christ the Son forever, asking their lives away. I am bound for the promise land. I am bound for the promise land. All will come and know me. I am bound. bear for the promise.
Most gracious God in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for this wonderful time that you have given to us. Thank you for the program that is arranged by Mr. and Mrs. Nabba Devadas, the storytelling program, which is very beneficial for all the children and the elders. At this time, we pray thee that this program will be a blessing to the troublesome world and the trouble that we are undergoing on this earth at this time, especially the COVID-19. Lord, we pray thee that you would protect those who are affected by this disease. Give them an escape from death and danger. Above all, Lord, forgive our sins and shortcomings. Finally, when you come in the clouds of heaven, grant all of us, Lord, a place in the eternal kingdom, because we pray in Jesus' name.